everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. You might think the games get more important as we get deeper into the season. Try selling that to this sellout crowd who's been screaming their guts out and ready for kickoff in the SEC. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
The battlefield for this matchup. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste at zero calories. Enjoy everything. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He's to the 20. At the 30. Taken down by the kicker. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. The stop right around the 40.
Let's go.
That'll make it second and seven.
Ready. Green 90.
He's at midfield. He's at the 40. Brought down at the 35-yard line.
Great run by the back there. He could have gone all the way.
Played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
And he's tackled at about the 13.
Just couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage. Loss of one.
That'll bring up third and four.
From the 7-yard line, third down.
And he throws right away.
Johnson's intended to see one play. That makes it fourth and four.
Louisiana Lafayette is looking to go up by three.
Kicks away.
And they tack on 3 points. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
Let's check in on some Big 12 action. And for SMU, they've now dumped 4 in a row.
That's good stuff, Reese. Thank you. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's out to the 30, and down he goes at the 32-yard line.
LSU's staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk. And I think they believe in their guy that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons. And I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
Second down and seven. Ball on the 35. Oh, and he had some steam on that throw. He's tackled at the 41.
Hawkins brings him down at the 41-yard line. First down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 41. He's gobbled up in the backfield. 2-yard loss for the halfback. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. He scrambled. They bring him down.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. He found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
Throws it out there, and he's hit immediately.
Here's a great example of what this man is capable of. As receivers go, he's as electric as they come.
From the 11-yard line, it's first down. Touchdown, Tigers! And he converts the extra point. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
We take you down to Ruston. This game was tighter than spandex on a sumo wrestler. Louisiana Tech prevails. They win by 5.
And we thank you, Reese Davis. Back to the action here. Crenshaw is lined up to kick this one off. He'll take it from the 2. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He's out to the 30. Slides down. Adams, the kind of athlete that you can build your entire offense around. His athleticism, second to none. We'll see if they have an answer for him today. Got some open field. He's at midfield. He's taken down at the 45. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
There's a strike complete.
He might have a chance.
And he shoved out of bounds at about the 37-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
Here we go.
Tackle at the 29. There before he stepped out of bounds.
He ran a good route to get this first down. Boy, the offense does a nice job here with play action to get the linebacker out of position to be able to convert.
Tackle made at about the 3 yard line.
Well, that's another first down, Brad. That's the fifth first down on this drive. You know, this offense isn't hitting a lot of big plays, but they're very, very consistent with their execution. It's putting a lot of pressure right now on this defense.
Taken down in the backfield. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one.
That brings up second and goal.
Touchdown, Ragin' Cajuns. Touchdown.
Once you get inside the 10-yard line, this halfback is automatic.
Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 9-play, 79-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, not only did they put points up on the board, but I think it's the way they did it. That could be demoralizing for defense.
The score now, 10-7, and it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 28. The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Quarter. The Ragin' Cajuns with a 3-point lead. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. And he snags that one. And he's taken down right around the 36-yard line. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. They'll bring him down at about the 39-yard line.
First down.
Run to the outside.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 44-yard line. Second down. Quick throw. And they make the stop at the 38.
That's a gain of 18 on the play. First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. They try the right side. Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
Time right. gets out to about the 28-yard line. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. And he's level at the 25.
This kind of execution from an offense can really affect the defense and their psyche. That's the second time on this drive alone they've been able to convert on a third down. This defense has got to be able to kind of gather themselves and try to find some confidence. And somebody on that defense has got to be able to make a play to slow this offense down.
From the 25-yard line, it's second down. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. Brought down at the 24.
That'll make it third and nine.
It's the 11th play of the drive. He's looking for six. That could have been a big play for the defense.
Yeah, even though he had a good shot at picking it off, it's still a heck of a play to force the incomplete pass.
They're going to try a long field goal here. LSU can tie it up here with this kick. It's up, looks long enough, and he splits the uprights.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
And a 10-10 tie in this game. Crenshaw has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. From his own goal line. And he's tackled at the 32.
Right, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. And a quick throw. He's tackled in the open field. Around the 36-yard line. He's on the run, and he's sacked.
He has one job on passing situations, get to the quarterback, and he did that job very, very well on that play.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. Steps out of bounds at about the 43-yard line.
That'll bring up third and long.
Tight right. Four down. Key 26.
Ready.
Oh, and almost picked off.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one. Wow, that was close.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. It's away. Short punt. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Quick pass. And he's tackled at about the 29-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. He's tackled around the 29-yard line. Looks like the defense was in man coverage there, fellas, and that's why they stopped that screen.
Yeah, and when the secondary isn't dropping back into zone, it makes it difficult to have success with that kind of screen play.
Set, as he works the right side.
The defense has got to do a better job of being more aggressive. You know, this offense doesn't seem to be in much of a hurry. They're working the clock. You know the chances are they're going to run the football. That allows the defense to pin their ears back and get aggressive. And it really comes down to the defensive linemen holding up against the offensive line and the linebackers and safeties crashing downhill and making plays against the run game.
Now he tries to buy some time. The Tigers are going to have to call their third and final timeout. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
First and 10. Ball on the 49. I guess he'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. Going for it all to the end zone. Missed him. So we've played two quarters. This one's all even at 10.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Rhys Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. One thing has been apparent in this first half that we just saw. Both defensive coordinators a step ahead of their counterparts on offense. They've had the answer for every formation, every shift, every movement, every motion that they've tried to come up with. So, to try to break free and get something moving on offense, might it be time to show a little trickeration?
A little trickeration never hurt nobody. I mean, it's something that if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're going to keep getting what you've been getting. And you got to find a way to do something a little bit different because it wasn't working. Let's find some new plays in that book. Let's run a little bit of option. Let's run a reverse. Let's run some double passes. How about we bring a blitz with everybody? Just don't even cover anybody. Just bring everybody. Bring the house. You know, try to do something a little bit out of the ordinary. Try to get a spark going for your ball club.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
All right, Rhys, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Bell fields it at the 9. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. He's to the 40. Inside the 30. Brought down with only one man to beat. First down. First down and 10 to go after the big gain on the run. There he goes. McKenzie picks up about 7 yards on the run.
7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
It out to his receiver in a hurry. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. What a throw for a big gain.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
First and goal from the 5. They're knocking on the door. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and goal.
He makes the PAT. A five-play, 70-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
They line up to kick this one away. Harvey fields it at the 2. He's taken down at the 27. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Wrestle him down in the backfield.
Loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll make it 3rd and 5.
It's 3rd and 5. Ball on the 32-yard line. Rolls out to the back, and he can't hold on to it.
Taylor was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up 4th and 5.
Locked is the punter. Looking for the corner. And he just got drilled. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
They'll work the left side. Nice run there. McKenzie gains about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
From the 48-yard line, 2nd down. LSU is up a score. Positive yardage.
That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
Here we go, here we go. Tight right.
He's taken down around the 37-yard line.
Gain of 6 on the play. That makes it 1st and 10.
From the 37-yard line, 1st down. Gains his way to the 23-yard line.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. First down.
He scrambled, looking for the corner. Tackle at the 23-yard line. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 23. He's pushed out of bounds at the 13.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. First down.
Gives it left side. Tackle made at the 4-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That'll make it 2nd and inches.
So it's 2nd down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the 1st down. LSU is up by a touchdown. Touchdown, Tigers! Splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the 1. He's tackled at the 27-yard line.
The Tigers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
He makes his way to about the 38.
I think he made a late read of the defense there. Quarterback needs to be much more decisive with his option reads.
Second down, and they've got 15 for the first down. Ball on their own 33. So at the end of the third quarter, LSU leads it 24-10. Quarter.
You don't want anyone, you don't get it. Pick up the ball.
Check 59, Mike. Mike.
Ready.
Pass right, running back's got it. He's knocked out of bounds at the 36.
Gain of three on the play. That makes it 3rd and 11.
A huge, huge stop here in the fourth quarter. They've got the lead. They're going to get the football back, but there's still a lot of ball left. Bell will be the return man. And he muffed it. Brought down at the 26-yard line.
I know I'd be nervous with 11 guys sprinting down the field at me, but the first job of a return man is to catch the ball.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Now he's scrambling, and they make the stop at the 28. From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. In the shotgun and five wideouts. He's going to try and scramble. And he's taken down right around the 30. It in a hurry. They'll bring him down to 39-yard line.
McKinney makes the tackle at the 39-yard line. First down.
It's 1st and 10. Ball on their own 39. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Second and six.
Just under three to go in regulation. Brought down around the 49-yard line.
First down.
From the 49-yard line, it's 1st down. Carries the ball for a nice game.
That's a gain of four.
Louisiana Lafayette just took their first time out. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. McKenzie picks up five with the carry. The Raging Cajuns call a timeout. That's their second of the half. And so it's another 3rd down upcoming here. gets it out to about the 30. Third down has been the charm on this drive.
Now, it's been all about execution. When it comes to calling the right play at the right time, they've been able to do it here.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. He gets out to about the 21-yard line. Short yardage situation here. Second down and 1. And down he goes at the 13-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it first.
This is the 11th play of this drive. Gets to about the 11-yard line. Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on the 11-yard line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. 13th play of the drive coming up. And so that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, 24-10, LSU. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.